Good evening, doctors. Welcome again. Today we are going to discuss about UPSC MCQs paper part B 2017 part 1. It's B part. We already discussed 60 MCQs. Now we are going to discuss here. An elderly patient had cerebrovascular accident which was diagnosed as ischemic in nature. Which of the following is contraindication for thrombolysis? So first option is onset of symptom is time of drug administration is 4.5 hours or gastrointestinal bleeding preceding 21 days. So answer here is second one is the right B, and thrombolysis are contraindicated because it aggravates the bleeding itself. Okay, now consider the following insulin preparation. Which of the following is short acting insulin? Aspart, glulisin and regular is short acting. As determinate is a long acting. So answer here is C, 1, 2 and 4. So answer is C. Now, a middle-aged male non-smoker present with recurrent sinusitis, hemoptysis, hematuria, arthralgia and palpable purpura. What is the most likely diagnosis here involves upper respiratory tract sinusitis, lower respiratory tract hemoptysis and renal involvement, hematuria, arthralgia, its joints involvement and palpable purpura. Is the diagnosis here clear cut Wegener's granulomatosis? A option is the right. Now, a patient present with diarrhea, steatorrhea and weight loss. Which of the following disease is least possible? Whipple's disease, tropical spruance, celiac possible, but Mantle's disease not possible. In Mantle's disease, very rare gastropathy characterized by large tortuous mucosal folds. Okay. And onset is 40 to 60 years. Now, consider the following statement regarding post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis. Immunosuppressive therapy is effective? No. Post-PSGN develop 1 to 3 weeks after streptococcal pharyngitis? Yes. PSGN is post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis. Develops 2 to 6 weeks after impetigo? Yes. The classical presentation is acute nephritis? Yes. So answer here is second, third, fourth. B option is the right. Now, a patient with long-term implantable cardioverter defibrillator device developed neck and facial swelling, hoarseness of voice, nasal congestion, dysphagia, and hemoptysis. The facial swelling increased on supine position. This patient most likely to develop superior vena cava obstruction. Yeah. Now, a patient of AIDS developed ophthalmoplasia, ataxia and global confusion. He is likely to have deficiency of thymine. These are the symptoms are hallmarks of acute Wernicke's disease. Okay. An elderly male present with persistent productive cough with large volume purulent sputum production. He has several episodes in the past. He also had digital clubbing. He is a case of bronchiectasis. So this is a case of bronchiectasis. Okay. Now, a chemical factory worker has acute onset of dyspnea, fever, chills and malaise. Following a few hours of exposure to a new chemical, these symptoms resolve in 4 to 5 days after removal from exposure. He is likely to have hypersensitivity pneumonitis. A option is the right. A 25-year-old man presents with nausea, vomiting and diarrhea with crampy abdominal pain. He gives history of consumption of rice preparation in his last meal. What is the likely organism causing the above complaint? That is Bacillus cereus. Is commonly present in rice. Now, a 5-year-old child was diagnosed with nephrotic syndrome 18 months back. He was treated and successfully went into remission. At that time, following the initial episodes, the child has had 3 relapses, each of which was successfully treated with oral prednisolone. Until remission followed 40 mg single dose alternate days 4 weeks. What is the diagnosis? Nephrotic syndrome with infrequent relapses. Okay. Now, a 7-year-old girl present to you with non-specific abdominal pain, mild abdominal distension and not growing well. The child weighs 14 kg and height 95 cm. Systemic examination is normal, hemoglobin 7.5, microcytic hypochromic and has not responded to iron therapy. Which of the following will be the first investigation you will be diagnosed the condition? It's TTG, tissue transglutaminase antibodies, represents celiac disease. Okay. A 7-year-old boy, weighed 20 kg, presented with bleeding from upper GI, hematemesis, for last 18 hours. On examination, pulse 86, respiratory 16, BP 100 by 70, spleen palpable 5 cm below costal margin. There is no other abnormality, liver function tests are normal. The best step in management is by intravenous vasopressin. Okay, B. A 7-year-old girl present in emergency room with hypertension, lethargy, headache, seizures and visual disturbance. Fundus examination reveals hemorrhage and exudates. Which of the following treatment regimen will be the most appropriate for this child? That is intravenous labetalol infusion. Okay. On routine newborn screening at day 3 of life, the baby was found to have TSH level 40. What should be the next step? Repeat thyroid profile within 1 week. In this case, TSH level 40 at his both possibilities of transient permanent congenital hypothyroidism are to be kept beyond 50. Most of the children have permanent CH. For babies 20 to 40, follow-up TSH level required for prompt treatment if there are feature of CH. Okay. A 5-year-old girl is brought to you with history of fever for 7 days associated with rash, anorexia, myalgia and petechial hemorrhage. Which of the following investigation will be the most appropriate for making a diagnosis of dengue fever? That is detection of IgM antibodies for dengue. It's acute infection. D option is the right. An 8-year-old boy was diagnosed to have Plasmodium vivax malaria and was treated with appropriate doses of chloroquine. The fever subsided but reoccurred after 3 weeks. Peripheral smear was again positive for P. vivax. The child should now be treated as a case of either relapse or recurrence. Okay, C. A 2-day-old neonate is bought with cyanosis, single second heart sound and pan systolic murmur on the left external border. ECG reveal left axis deviation, right atrial overload, left ventricular hypertrophy. What is the most likely diagnosis? Most likely diagnosis is tricuspid atresia. Now, A 3-year-old girl bought with complaints of not being able to ever stand or walk. She achieved head control at 1 year of age. Examination revealed generalized hypotonia, brisk knee jerk and ankle clonus. What is the likely diagnosis? It's cerebral palsy. A option is right. Child present with sensation of itching, burning and probable foreign body band, the eyelids. Examination reveals photophobia, large oval follicles, within conjunctiva and periauricular adenopathy. The most likely diagnosis is, here it's a diagnosis of epidemic keratoconjunctivitis. A option is right. A 7-year-old boy present with acute onset of mild trance, intermittent pain in the right groin and limb. Abduction and internal rotation of the hip were restricted on the affected side. There was no fever. Radiographs of the pelvis were normal. The most likely diagnosis here is it's transient monoarticular synovitis. Okay. It's a reactive arthritis is one of the most common cause of hip pain in a young children. So guys, hope it's clear. A child bought with history of ingestion of unknown substance. On examination, child has excess salivation, lacrimation, meiosis, gastrointestinal cramps and emesis. What is the most likely substance ingested? That is carbamates or phosphates, we can say. Okay. A term newborn present with respiratory failure which is refractory to mechanical ventilation, surfactant replacement therapy, glucocorticoid administration and extracorporeal membrane oxygenation. The most likely diagnosis here is surfactant protein B deficiency. A. A child after a snake bite develops petechia and ecchymosis on a skin. In addition, child develops bleeding from venipuncture site of oliguria. The most likely snake species is pit viper. Snake venom are a complex mixture of proteins, include large enzyme cause local tissue destruction and low molecular weight polypeptides. So viper venoms can be deleterious effect on almost any organ system. Most viper bites can cause significant local pain, swelling, ecchymosis, result necrosis, bitten extremity, pain and swelling typically being quickly after the bite of progress over 2 days. Serious envenomations may result in consumptive coagulopathy, hypotension and respiratory distress. Okay. A 6-year-old boy present with short neck, low hairline, restriction of neck movement. The child has spingeal anomalies, scoliosis and few cervical vertebrae. The most likely diagnosis is Klippel-Feil syndrome. B is right. Triad of low posterior hairline, short neck, decreased cervical range of motion. Okay. 10-year-old boy present with recurrent bouts of nasal congestion, itching, sneezing, clear rhinorrhea, conjunctival irritation. On examination, he has conjunctival hyperemia, allergic gap, and a transverse nasal crease. Which of the following drug is preferred for the management of the child is fluticasone? B option is right. A 2-year-old child present with partial albinism and susceptibility to infection. Peripheral smear examination reveals gent peroxidase, positive lysosomal granules and granulocytes. Which of the following is the most likely diagnosis? Cherik-Higashi syndrome. Okay. It's autosomal recessive disorder, increased susceptibility to infection, oculocutaneous albinism, peripheral neuropathy, tendency to develop life-threatening form, hemophagocytic lymphohistiocytosis. Okay. A 1-year-old child on exclusive milk feeds present with constipation. On examination, there is no fecal impaction. What is the next step in the management? Increase the intake of various vegetables and cereals. The diet, most children functionally constipation lack fibers. Okay. A 6-year-old boy present with generalized seizures, disorder of hypopigmented skin lesion. On examination, has tiny red nodules over the nose and cheeks. The most likely diagnosis here is tuberous sclerosis. A option is right. Okay. Now, which of the following can cause bilateral sensory neuronal hearing loss by loop diuretics? C. 91. The joint sitting of parliament for transacting the legislative business is presided over by the speaker of Lok Sabha. D. Recently, massive coral bleaching has been reported in the Great Barrier Reef. It located near the coast and it located near the Queensland. Okay. The Great Barrier of Reef in the world is coral reef system, Coral Sea coast of Queensland or Australia. Who is the first law officer in government of India? That is Attorney General of India. Okay. Now, in the context of genetic engineering, scientists have developed a new computational method called target finder, which can predict where non-coding DNA interacts with genes. Which of the following is likely advantage of this? Artificial induction, beneficial mutations so as to develop high yielding varieties, finding new drug target to treat some genetic disease, rapid cloning and domesticated animals, or D, all of the above. So all of the above is the right answer. Now, consider the following. Which of the following above is a e-waste? Gold, platinum, silver, all three. C option is the right. 1, 2, 3, C is the right. Now, boil a small quantity of khoya with some water, cool, and add a few drops of iodine solution. and see the formation of blue color. This is the test to find the presence of which of the following is starch. C option is right. Which of the following cannot be used as biofertilizer in a rice cultivation, that is rhizobium? Now, groundwater in many areas in West Bengal has been contaminated, leading to large number of cases of poisoning. What is the substance responsible for such cases? Arsenic. Arsenic. Okay. For acquiring ethanol to blending with petrol, the oil companies in India depends on cosmetic injuries. No. In sugar mills. So answer is sugar mills. Consider the following statement. Targeted delivery in financial and other subsidized benefits and services acts 2016 aim to strengthen the Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana, provide funds to relieve the farmers. D, it's neither. 1 and 2. Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana aims to promote financial inclusion. A. Now, the objective of Parampragat Krishi Vikas Yojana is to promote is organic farming. Yeah. Which among the following is very water intensive crop, that is sugarcane? C, water intensive crop. Which of the following does not non-science have applications? Drug delivery, electronics, food poisoning, water putrefaction. Select the code given below correct answer. So 1, 2, 3, 4, all 4 is right. Which of the following is the exclusive power of Lok Sabha as compared to Rajya Sabha? Inducing money bill, passing the motion, or no confidence against the council minister? Answer is C, it's both. Who among the following do not participate the election of President of India, that is elected member by Vidhan Parishad? D. There is a popular opposition to use of plastic micro beds, the manufacture of which of the following they used, that is cosmetics, is right. Consider the following statement. In certain part of India, the cultivation opium is legally allowed. Yes. Opium gum is mixed with cluster beam gum franking technology that is used to shale gas extraction. So answer here is 1 only correct. Now, there is a worldwide protest against the hydrofluorocarbons in which of the following household things they use, that is air conditioning machines. A. What is the objective of Cartagena Protocol on biosafety? Establish promoting C2 conservation facilities, rare endangered organisms, maintaining the worldwide network of gene banks to all of flora and fauna. So answer is D, neither. Consider the following elements. Which of the following above India there is natural habitat? It's log bear and log gibbon. So first and third. Yeah. Consider the following statement. Biodiversity is normally greater in the lower altitude as compared to higher altitude. Along the mountain gradient, biodiversity is normally greater in the lower altitudes as compared to the higher altitudes. Okay, so answer is 1. C option, both are right. Now, aflatoxins are formed by Aspergillus flavus. A. Consider the following districts. Which of the following districts well known for tea plantation? It's Munnar, Mandi, MM, remember. So answer is first and second, C option is right. Yeah. Fly ash is emitted from thermal power plants, D. Calcium carbide is used as for fruit ripening, C. With reference to food additives, consider the following statement. Benzoic acid and sorbic acid function as antimicrobial agents, true. Citric acid is used to suppress browning of fruits and vegetables, yes. Browning. The following statement is correct. So first and second both are correct. C option is right. Now, with reference to the use of microorganism in food processing, consider the following statements. Lactic acid-based Bacteria can ferment many monosaccharides or polysaccharides into lactic acid. Baker's yeast manufacture single cell isolate saccharomyces services. So correct answer is neither 1 and 2. Its answer is 2 only. Baker's yeast manufacture from single cell isolates saccharomyces services. Okay. Which of the following chemical is used for food preservation? Calcium proponent, yes. Potassium metabisulfite, yes. Lecithin, yes. So 1, 2, 3, all 3 are right. C option is right. Now, what is M-suggestion sometimes seen in news? It's initiative to help tobacco users to quit tobacco. No. Mobile phone services that delivers audio message on pregnancy, childbirth to childcare. No. It is on tobacco users to quit tobacco. So answer here is A. A's answer. M-suggestion program is a tobacco quit tobacco. So guys, have a good day. Goodbye. I hope you already understand this. And so those who are still not, go through the 2017 UPSC CMS paper part A. Go through that. And this is part B. And second I am going to launch soon. So have a good day. Goodbye. That's all for today.